everyone. In this edition of Classroom Digital Tools, Bubby here, the feline tech guru, is going to help supervise us as we review how to use Google Calendar. So Bubby, are you ready? He looks ready. Let's go. Hello everyone, in today's video we're going to take a look at how to use a shared Google Calendar. And a shared Google Calendar can be very useful. It can be used by multiple people for planning events, or in this particular example, for reserving computer cards within a school system. Once a Google Calendar has been shared with you, you should receive an email such as this one right here. Clicking on this email, you'll say, hello, your email address, we are writing to let you know that so-and-so has given you access to view events on the Google Calendar called Computer Cart Reservations. We have automatically added this calendar to your Google Calendar account. You can hide or completely remove this calendar at any time. So to actually access the calendar, you can either click on this link here that says View Your Calendar, or you can go over here to the Google Apps Manager, which looks like a checkerboard. Click on it, and then go down and click on the app that says Calendar. Clicking on this opens up the Google Calendar, and you can see all of the events listed for the week. To continue with this demonstration, however, I'm going to log out my personal email account and log into my Johnson County Schools work email account. So I'm signing out, and I'm signing back in under my work email. Okay. Now, one of the strengths of using a shared Google Calendar to make computer cart reservations is that it will empower teachers to make reservations from home, from their smartphone, as well as from their work devices. Upon opening your Google Calendar, you will see all the events for the entire week. You can instead click on Day to just see the events listed for that particular day. You can also click on Month to see everything listed for the month, 4 days, and what is sometimes very convenient, clicking on the agenda, so that way you can see a listing of events for different days of the week. Going back to Day, I'm going to move forward from Sunday, October 1st, over into Monday, October 2nd, and can go back and forth between days by using these backward and forward arrows. If you feel that there are too many events being shown on your Google Calendar, please do not click on the events and delete them. By deleting them, yes, you will make the item disappear from your Google Calendar, but you will also make it disappear from the calendars of everyone to whom the Computer Cart Reservations Google Calendar was shared. This will cause mass chaos. Instead, if there are too many events showing on your calendar, simply click on the square representing the calendar on the left of the screen, and it will make that particular calendar go away. To bring it back, you click on it again. This way, you will be able to unclutter your calendar without deleting events from other people's agendas. Before making a computer cart reservation, make certain that no one else has already reserved it. And one very easy way of checking on that is to click on the word agenda up here, and then you can quickly scroll through this in this simple list to see whether or not anyone has scheduled a particular cart. In this example, I'm looking for card 17, and since I don't see it listed here, I'm going to go ahead and make a reservation. So I will click back on the day. And to make a reservation, I can either go to the create icon over here and quickly add in reservation and then click the button that says add. Or alternatively, I can click on an empty space in the calendar and enter in the details. In this case, card 17. After entering in the card number, enter in your name. Then enter in the location where you will have the card. The next thing that you need to do is make certain that your event will be posted on the correct calendar. Currently, by default, it is being posted on the calendar that says Daniel Barrett. The problem with that is if I make the event only on the Daniel Barrett calendar, the only person who will be able to see it will be me, since personalized calendars are private. So to switch over to the computer cart reservations calendar, I click on this box right here, choose computer cart reservations, and now I will go to edit event, and I will enter in the time frame for which I will need the cart. Although the easiest thing to do is to click on all day and thereby reserve the cart for yourself all day, that is preventing other people from being able to use that particular card during your planning period. So please, only reserve a card for the actual times that you're going to be needing it. For this example, I'm going to be reserving the card for 7 a.m. until 8:40. And notice that I will need to make adjustments to the time. If we are running a special schedule that day, please adjust the times according to the new bell schedule. If you would like, you can enter in the location information in here. Although really, that is not needed since it is already listed up here in the descriptive bar. You can also indicate information down here about why you're using it, such as testing, but again, that's not really needed. You can change the event color here to whatever you would like, and if you know that you're going to need this particular card over multiple days for the same time frame, you may click on repeat, and it gives you some options. So for this example, let's say I will need it every weekday. And I will have it expire on, and make certain that you change the calendar to indicate this, October 6th. And then I click on Done once I'm happy with what it says. So the way this is currently set up is I have card 17 reserved for myself in the media center from 7 a.m. until 8:40 a.m. from October 2nd through October 6th. Just make certain that if you need to make a reservation for multiple days, that no one else has that card reserved on any of those days for that same time period. When you are done, click on Save. And now you can see that reservation here on the calendar. Clicking on it confirms that it's in under Computer Cart Reservations. Looking at the rest of the week, I'm confirming that no one else has it reserved, and it looks like I am in the clear. Up here in these two top bars, you see two carts that were scheduled to be used all day. Again, considering that every teacher has a planning period, please endeavor to use a cart only during the classes that you will actually need it. In addition, if you make a reservation for the entire day, people may not see that reservation if they are using their smartphone. If a person is using their smartphone to make a reservation, they will only see the all-day reservations by scrolling through a drop-down list. And this is something that can be easily missed, so please do not schedule a cart for the entire day. Make it available for other teachers for their planning period. If you are away from the current date, you can return to it by simply clicking on today. And I'm going to move forward to Monday again. If later on you change your mind about your reservation, simply go to it and click on it, and then click on delete. And then, since this event occurs over multiple days, you are given choice, only this instance, all following, or all events in series. All events in series will remove this cart reservation for myself for Monday through Friday. So I'm going to click on all events in series, and now it has been deleted from the calendar. So just to recap a few important things, never go in and delete someone else's reservation. Also, if you delete anything on a shared calendar, you are deleting it for everyone. To make a particular calendar's entries disappear from your calendar, simply click on it over here in the left-hand column under My Calendar. And it will disappear from your view, but the data will not have been erased. Also, never double book a computer cart. By doing so, you will create confusion during the day. Make certain that when you make a reservation that you're using the computer cart reservations calendar. If you don't change this, you will be making it on your private calendar, and no one else will be able to see that reservation except for you. Also, please do not reserve a cart for the entire day. Make it available for other teachers to use during their planning period. In addition, for consistency, please always include the cart number, your name, and your room location where you will be using the cart. At all times, please show professional respect towards your colleagues, since we have a limited number of carts that must be shared amongst many teachers. If you believe that someone has changed your reservation or deleted it, please let me know. I have this calendar set up so that when anyone ever makes a change to an event on the calendar or adds an event, I will get an automatic email. And here you can see a new event was created. This event was updated, etc. So I can dig back and try and determine who made changes to various events in the calendar. So please, do not make changes to other people's events, unless of course you first get their permission. Thank you for watching this edition of Classroom Digital Tools. Please share this video with others, like it, comment upon it, and subscribe to my channel. Bubby and I here greatly appreciate your support. Thank you and have a great day!